Sitting on the Amalfi coast, just outside the center of Positano, the Sirenuse is an old family home turned into a hotel in the 1950s. A place with a deep sense of history and a cultured atmosphere preserved through time.
Well, this hotel was started in 1951 by my father, two brothers and a sister. During World War II, they moved to Positano to avoid the bombings in Naples. And after the war, they decided to turn the house where they spent the summer into a hotel. And it opened with around 12 rooms in 1951. What I think this hotel makes it very special is that a family house that's been converted into a hotel. So it maintains very much the feeling, the atmosphere of a private house. It's more a house than a hotel. And so the way that people behave, the way that people act, the way that people interact with the staff is very much the feeling of a private house.
Once the summer retreat of the Sersale family, every room at Le Sirenuse feels crafted. The majolica tiles, the museum-worthy antics, the tall French windows that open onto sun-drenched terraces. Like John Steinbeck once said, it's a dream place that isn't quite real when you are there and becomes becognitively real after you have gone.
And you have a lot of traditional hotels in the region. How do you stay traditional, because I think it's very important to keep the tradition, but also turn step by step a bit to the future?
Well, I think that's the great challenge with hotels, you see, because you don't want them to become a museum, because if they become a museum, then they're very boring. They have to be alive and they have to be something that, like a living organism, that the guest comes back year after year and finds changes but doesn't even realize that they're changes. And you just have to invest, basically. Invest in the rooms, invest in the product, invest in new ideas, collaborate with architects, with designers, you know.
And what about the chef here? Because the cuisine, of course, in Italy is very important. He's here, I think, since 8 years, something like this.
Yeah, the chef is brilliant. Young, talented, we believe in him. He comes from this area. He comes from the foot of Mount Vesuvius. He knows tremendously well the ingredients. And so that is a very important, you know, and a lot of the dishes really come from his heart. They're dishes that maybe his mother might have made, his grandmother. They're dishes that are in his DNA.
Bonjour chef, alors qu'est-ce qu'on va préparer aujourd'hui?
Bah alors aujourd'hui on fait une recette très simple de la cuisine napolitaine, mais quand même faite avec un peu d'amour. Un peu de technique qu'on a pris autour du monde.
C'est des tomates que j'ai blanchies, refroidies dans l'eau et les glaçons pour lever la peau et basta così. Là, si je suis un petit peu ici, chaud.
Voilà. On va terminer la cuisson de la pasta dans la casserole.
D'accord. Okay. On termine toujours la cuisson dans la sauce en fait.
Toujours, parce qu'il faut que l'amidon de la pasta il va rester dans la sauce et va créer la liaison.
Ah bah bien sûr que je vous goûte.
Okay. Alors qu'est-ce qu'il pense?
Je pense que c'est pas mal, hein.
Merci. Merci beaucoup. On peut le dire, c'est très bon.
Allez. C'est super bon. Ce que j'aime beaucoup, c'est ce qu'apporte l'olive par-dessus.
Oui.
Là.
C'est un point meilleur comme ça.
Alors c'est rigolo parce que moi,
pourquoi?
J'ai toujours l'impression que le poulpe, ça va être élastique et... un peu caoutchouc.
En
alors
produit,
que là, pas du tout.
Ça fond dans
c'est
la bouche.
C'est hyper fondant.
Oui.
Et c'est super bon. Hein.
Ça fond dans la bouche. Mais c'est le produit, c'est pas moi.
Bon, un peu quand
un
même.
Peu moi aussi.
Merci, chef.
Avec plaisir.
I'm the third generation of Le Sirenuse. I've grown up surrounded by hospitality. And a family which has nurtured this family home and turned it into the hotel it is today. You know, the family really runs this hotel as if it was their private residence that they are welcoming the guests into. started this summer with a sort of shift in the language or the shift in the concept of the restaurant. We've decided to bring it back to a more traditional concept that focuses on the best ingredients from the region.
We're plant lovers, basically, and there are more plants than people in the hotel. So especially in the summertime, you know, a lot of the people come and they look at them, and we have a lot of ornamental plants inside, and we have a lot of Italian, well, say Mediterranean plants outdoors.
Do you have any idea of the number of plants you have in the hotel?
Oh, that's a good question. I'd say about 1,000 plants in the
wow.
hotel.
Incredible.
Between all the little orchids in the rooms, the plants that are outside and the terraces, which are in soil.
Because what is incredible here is that the garden is not outdoor, but the garden is everywhere in the hotel.
Everywhere.
You brought
everywhere.
The garden inside.
But it is a part of the Italian tradition to have indoor plants. So here we have the beautiful bougainvilleas. The whole entire restaurant is filled with bougainvillea vines climbing up at the arches. And this is the idea of just covering the entire arched ceiling with bougainvillea. So these are the chandeliers, and this is my uncle Franco's idea. And he's had them made especially for us. And they resemble plants, of course, because coming down from the ceilings, which are covered with the beautiful bougainvillea vines, they could be nothing else but beautiful leaves. The branches of this chandelier, and all the chandeliers in our restaurant are made of leaves.
But these I love what lovely. You did with the red of the walls, the
yes.
yellow, the green,
yes.
the white. It just gives an incredible impression. Huh?
It is beautiful. And here you see all the beautiful, these are the Californian bougainvilleas, the red ones. Californian red, San Diego red. That's that one. And then it's inside, the purple one, yeah. is the Sanderiana, which is typical of this area. So here you see the two different kinds of bougainvilleas.
Yeah. Well, you really did some magic. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you. And
you're
it's
welcome,
an incredible
Ivan.
Decor.
So I wanted to talk to you a little bit about some of the artworks that we have in the hotel, because it's a combination of the old and the new. That, for example, is a painter, Carlo Amalfi, from the area that paints an Italian nobleman.
Yeah.
And then if we come down here instead, here we have a wonderful mural by Alex Israel. Alex Israel is an LA-based artist, and this is a site-specific installation. He came here for a few days, he got inspired by the hotel, and he decided to create this work of art. So we have this program, this art program, which is all site-specific based. So what we do is we invite an artist every year for a few days. He comes here, he sees the hotel, he or she decides what they want to do, and then, of course, they suggest it, they do it, we purchase it, install it, and it remains. So here, for example, you have a painting of a cardinal that was in our family.
Yes.
This is Cardinal Antonino Sersale. And he's looking at a painting by Stanley Whitney. And Stanley Whitney is an amazing contemporary artist, New York-based, but has a studio in Italy, spends a lot of time in Italy. He's a great lover of Italy. So I thought, you know, and he does this body of work, which is absolutely filled with life, with color, with joy, and it's just a pleasure to see.
It's not often that you come across a place and it never quite leaves you. Le Sirenuse is just that, with its simple pleasures and thoughtful details. And traditions kept alive by generations of the Sersale family with the same passion and good taste.